What up, though? It's the music scene. We got all the action, all the smoke. Hit that subscribe button. If you haven't already subscribed to the channel, hit the notification bell to be notified when we drop another banger. We got that boy, Tekashi69. Now, I knew this was coming. Now, y'all might have already heard this, but I just got to tap in on it one more time. So, you know, the court ordered Tekashi69 to snitch indefinitely, like forever. So, when he get out, after this next year he served, he still got to be an informant for the rest of his life. Now, when you think about that, I guess it is still a good deal compared to 37 years or something like that. But, I knew this was coming. It was too good to be true. So, I knew he wasn't just going to be able to do a few years and 2 or 3 years and just be out and be done. So, I already knew this. So, yeah, he going to have to move to Europe or do something like that. And even over there, he's state property forever. That's crazy. So, all that stuff he gave up, he's state property. So, what y'all think about that? Let me see what else we got. But WAC 100, he kind of defend him. So, WAC 100 was on this radio show, and he was saying Tekashi really ain't do nothing wrong. And so, he kind of made a comparison on an actual radio show. One of the hosts is actually a gay guy. And so he was saying, his analogy or his example was that we had a party and all of us straight men was in here, and then y'all let, the dude, the gay guy in there, and then he caused some mischief. Then it's on us who let him in. It's our fault, not his fault. So basically, he's saying any people who was in the Tekashi corner, management, songwriter, anybody who made a beat for him, anybody did promotion for him, anybody did security for him, anybody who, was in agreement with his movement, they to blame. And so some people think that, WAC 100 trying to get close and be cool, so maybe he can do some work with him or manage him or something. But, what y'all think about that? Because WAC quick to go in and say, people not street or, they a snitch or whatever it is. And he definitely just gave him a pass. So what y'all think about it? So get in a comment, let me know what y'all think. See what else we got in here. So NBA YoungBoy. So they from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. No snow there. So they been in Utah, Salt Lake City, Utah, where some snow is. So you see on the different people in the family, friends, music associates or whatever. You see them Rich the Kid, Money Yaya, different people like that. You see they out there vacationing. And so they just living it up. Seem like they ain't really, worried about the drama or whatever was going on. Just having fun. I guess they wanted to have a white Christmas. I think that's kind of dope, though. The people who be from the South or whatever, that never really seen snow. And so I think that's kind of dope. All right, 50 Cent and Cuban Link, his girl. Now, I'm pretty sure that they done broke up. I done seen some stuff a few days ago that was questionable. I seen one post that I don't see no more on Cuban Link page that says all my Christmas gifts is at the store still. And I seen 50 Cent Nia Long picture and say, I like this picture. I see 50 Cent had an Instagram, it might have been a story, and he was saying I think he had bought the Bugatti. He's like, I gotta buy this new. He's like, I gotta buy new stuff, all new stuff, get rid of old stuff. So I started to feel people don't love me no more, or something like that. So I had to get all new stuff. It seemed like he was kind of throwing a little pot shot at Cuban Link. So I don't know. Neither one of them came out and said nothing, but that would just seem like I don't see them liking each other's pictures no more. I kind of went through the pictures. I don't really see no old pictures with them in there on Instagram or anything that they had. So. Y'all know something? Get a comment, let me know. You seen, I'm out. Cheap.